They call it a tax harmonization, but really they should label this a tax grab. Ontario is the latest province to harmonize the federal and provincial taxes. While both governments may be now singing from the same page, the song is how to stick it to the taxpayer. Last month, the Ontario government released its latest budget, one in which it found itself a few billion dollars short. Maybe it's just a coincidence, but in the same budget, the government agreed to combine its tax with the federal government's 5% GST. The math seems pretty simple. An 8% provincial tax and a 5% GST adds up to 13%, right? Wrong. The problem is the province is now going to begin taxing a host of new products it never taxed before. If you heard a loud growl from the housing industry, it's because the 8% tax will be applied on new homes. That's just what the industry needs. I can see the sales pitch. You're worried now about the right time to purchase a home? I got a deal for you. We'll charge you an extra 8% to buy that home. New homes under 400 grand are exempt. Okay, there's a few other things that will receive exemptions, like children's clothing, prescription drugs, basic groceries. But what about the things that will still be taxed? Don't start smoking, kids. Cigarettes will have that 13% taxed on their final cost. Let's say I did want to get in shape. I'd have to pay the harmonized tax on my gym membership. At least I have an excuse now not to go to the gym. Forget about me growing my hair out. There's a harmonized tax on haircuts. Even the cost of being buried, yes, funerals, will not be exempt from the new combined tax. I've heard all the arguments. It simplifies the process for filing taxes for businesses. Tax costs will also be lowered for businesses, and they'll be passed on to consumers. I'm waiting for it all to happen. Until it does, this harmonization will be another example of how our lives are marred by taxes. Thank you.